श्री राधा वल्लभ लाल की जय, श्री सद्गुरुदेव भगवान की जय, श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय, श्री हरिवंश। As per the instructions, as per the guidance, and by the grace of Pooja Maharajji, I am here to directly translate whatever Pooja Maharajji has said about Sri Vrindavan Dham and the divine love of Sri Priya Pritam in his Hindi lectures. So I am here to directly translate whatever Pooja Maharajji has discussed about the transcendental nectar of Sri Priya Pritam so that it could reach a wider range of audience, because Hindi is acts as a barrier at some level, because everybody cannot understand Hindi language. So this humble effort has been put forward so that we could reach a wider variety of audience, wider population, so that this divine love, this message of divine love of Pooja Maharajji, of the various acharyas, can reach them. So this is the direct translation, this is the direct views, direct speech of Maharajji, just converted by me in English. So don't take this discussion as my point of view. It has nothing to do with my ideology. And so whatever good, whatever beneficial you find in this discussion, take it as the direct grace of Maharajji. And whatever faults, whatever mistakes you do find, please ignore them, considering me as a beginner. I humbly bow down to everybody present. Sri Harivansh. Moving ahead with today's shlokas from Sri Vrindavan Mahimamrit, here we go. Janat napyamritam vihay garalam bhunje swayam बंधनम प्यारे तीव्रातनि निबंधन दृढ़तरम कुर्वे सुदृक् स्वं धवत श्री वृंदाटवी मातरेकमिहि मज्जे जीवातुरस्ति स्वयं यत्वं स्नेहा मयि विकृष्य जनतां स्वां कं समानेष्यसि। इमेंसली कंपैशनेट, बाउंडलेसली मर्सिफुल, लिबरेटर टू ऑल द फॉलन सोल्स, प्रोवाइडर ऑफ डिवाइन लव ऑफ श्री प्रिया प्रीतम इन द हार्ट्स ऑफ ऑल दोज पीपल हु हैव टेकन द शेल्टर ऑफ दिस लैंड एंड हैव टेकन अ वाव, हैव टेकन अ प्लेज that they'll never leave the boundary of this place during their lifetime. Such is the glory, such is the importance, such is the splendor of Sri Vrindavan Dham. Prabodhanand Path Saraswati Ji is, in this particular shlok, is acting like a small child, is requesting like a small child, and as if when a small child pleads to his mother, prays to his mother, requests his mother, what is the interaction, what is the sentiment that child possess? The same sentiment, the same feeling, the same behavioral attribute Prabodhanand Path Saraswati Ji is describing in this shloka. Let's have a look what he's saying. He's saying that, O Vrindatavi, O Mother Vrindatavi, he is addressing Vrindavan Dham to be the most compassionate mother of everybody, mother to all those fallen souls who are caught in the cobweb of this materialism, who are entangled, who are completely blind in this the cobweb, or the whole, what we say, the enigma that the material energy, the maya of Supreme Lord, that has created all this materialism. So Prabodhanand Path Saraswati Ji is requesting Vrindavan Dham that, O Mother Vrindatavi, please be kind on me, please be compassionate on me, and like a child who has no knowledge and who has no intellect and who is just simply moving around here and there without any brains, without any knowledge of what is right, what is wrong. Similarly, he's saying that, ओ वृंदावन धाम, ओ मदर वृंदावन, आई एम लाइक अ चाइल्ड टू यू, अ चाइल्ड हु हैज नो नॉलेज, हु हैज नो ब्रेन्स, प्लीज बी काइंड इनफ ऑन मी एंड कीप मी इन जस्ट लाइक अ मदर प्लेसेज हिज चाइल्ड ऑन हिज लैप एंड जस्ट बाउंड्स हिम और हर एंड नेवर लीव्स हिम और नेवर लेट हिम गो एनीवेयर इन एंड जस्ट टाइटली होल्ड्स हर, हग्स हर, इन दैट मैनर ओनली प्रबोधानंद पाद सरस्वती जी महाराज इज रिक्वेस्टिंग वृंदावन धाम दैट ओ वृंदावन धाम यू आर लाइक अ मदर टू मी, प्लीज बी काइंड इनफ ऑन मी एंड नेवर लेट मी गो आउट ऑफ द बाउंड्री ऑफ श्री वृंदावन धाम, नेवर पुश मी आउटसाइड द बाउंड्री ऑफ वृंदावन धाम, ऑल्दो I know that I am leaving the elixir, the nectar, and I am after all these material things, material attractions are there in my heart. I know that these all things are wrong, and I should not be doing this. Like all of us, this is the condition Prabodhanand Pad Saraswati ji is describing. Actually, he is describing our condition only. The fallen souls like us who are involved in all the activities, who have this notion in their mind that the only purpose of this life is to just get into the various materialistic attributes, various materialistic luxuries, various materialistic desires, attractions that the material energy, the Maya of Lord offers to us. And we, although everybody has this knowledge that what is right, what is wrong, everybody knows that this all is temporary, this is not permanent at all, but still, due to that imperfection, due to the layers of impurities in our mind, we continue to go on and just run after all these materialistic desires, all these futile temporary desires which we have, that okay, we should go and achieve this, we should do this, do that, we should have all the money, we should have good land, we should have good house, we should have these many fleet of cars, and so on. Our desire list goes on and on and on. This is what Prabodhanand Pad Saraswati ji Maharaj is saying, that I know what is the actual elixir of life is all about and what is the true taste of it. But due to the ignorance, due to the all the impurities that are there in my mind, I'm unable to judge it and I'm unable to get myself on the right track. And I am driven by the blindness of my mind, my intellect is not working in a proper manner, and I'm running after all these materialistic desires, although somewhere in my mind, somewhere in my brain, I have this idea that what is right and what is wrong. So, like a mother, like a compassionate guardian to me, a guiding factor to me, why don't you just push me onto the right track? Why don't you behave like a true compassionate soul to me, and why don't you please push me on the right track? Because I don't have that knowledge, I don't have that courage, I don't have that ability in myself, I don't find any now power in myself that I can guide myself, or my brain is that sharp enough to guide me on the right track. So please Vrindavan Dham, please I beg before you, that I know that this is, whatever I'm doing is all wrong, whatever I'm involved into is all wrong, but you being a true mother, please guide me on the right track. Then he further says that although I have got eyes, everybody have got eyes, but these eyes, I'm not using them to prop, I'm not utilizing the knowledge which could be used, which could be extracted. For example, although if I know that there's a well out near to me, and I know if I go, I'll fall into that well, or there's a pit, if I ignore that, there's a pit on a road and I'm just about to cross that, and I have Lord has given me the eyes that if I go around that path and I ignore it, then I'll definitely fall in that pit. Similarly, I have eyes and I can see that these are the pits of materialism that are all spread, all this material energy has spread it all these desires, attractions are kind of pits, all are the huge, what we call, these are holes which can make us fall into them and we'll be left there for ages. But having these good eyes also, we are ignoring them, we are unable to walk properly. So Prabodhanand Pad Saraswati Ji Maharaj is saying that, he's laying stress on this point that although we have got eyes, although we have got the knowledge there, the knowledge, everybody has the knowledge because we are part and parcel of the ocean of knowledge, the Supreme Lord. We are the part of that Supreme Personality, Mamai Vansho Jeev. Lord Krishna is saying in Bhagavad Gita that every soul, every body present is my part. He is the extension of my energy. He is the extension of my form only. But due to the layers of material energy that are instilled in his heart, instilled in his mind, instilled in his intellect, instilled in his brain, he has forgotten the real relation. And he's like wandering here and there in search of all these futile desires and to attain or complete these futile desires. So we need to focus that these materialism that has encircled us is not letting us see what is the right track, what is the right path, and we are just involving ourselves more and more into these material bondages. What could be the material bondages which are letting us just getting us more deep into this cobweb or this pit of materialism, like our relations with our family members, our wife, our mother, our father, our friends, our son, daughter, XYZ. All these material bondages are such which are not letting us go beyond this level of materialism. What is that beyond state? That is the divine love, that is the divine pastimes of Priya Pritam that are happening on this beautiful land of Sri Vrindavan Dham. So Prabodhanand Pad Saraswati Ji Maharaj is saying that I know that I've got the eyes, but I'm ignoring the knowledge that is instilled in my eyes, and I am still involving myself into all these materialistic bondages. So here in this shlok, the main purpose of Prabodhanand Pad Saraswati Ji is to just plead. He is completely relying himself, he has completely surrendered himself to the land of Sri Vrindavan Dham and is saying that I have no ability, I have no power, I have no capability. I have the only thing that I have in my mind is that you are mine, you are mine. So this relation, this strength of relation is the only guiding force, is the only power instilled in me that gives me some enthusiasm, some inspiration that okay, I can also achieve that divine love of Priya Pritam. I can see my condition, I can see the prevailing, all those prevailing thoughts of my mind, my brain, my intellect, how they are working and how miserable my condition is all about, how miserable is my situation. But I have faith, I have complete faith on the divine land of Sri Vrindavan Dham, and I know that it's a mother to me, and like a mother never leaves his child, because the child has no knowledge. He's like, sometimes he might like to play with snakes, he like to play with fire, he would like to jump in the well, but the mother won't allow him. Mother would always be behind him to protect him. If he tries to like play with snake, or he tries to take the knife and just play around it, then he'll get a slap from his mother, and mother will immediately protect him and just throw that knife away and just take him in her arms. So this is the condition what Vrindavan Dham does, and Prabodhanand Pad Saraswati Ji Maharaj is asking Vrindavan Dham to do that. I have no power, no ability, not at all. I completely rely upon you, Vrindavan Dham, and I know that out of the utmost compassion, out of the utmost mercy, you will definitely pamper me, you will definitely purify me, you will definitely let me or bring me that to that level where I could meet Sri Priya Pritam. Now one thing, the interesting part is that the glory of Vrindavan Dham is such that it is not even allowing Sri Krishna, Sri Priya Pritam to, they are unable to go out of the boundary of this land. They are so attracted, they are so much in love with this land of Vrindavan Dham that even they can't think to go outside this land of Vrindavan Dham. So how can a person like a fallen soul like us can even think if Vrindavan Dham holds us back? So this is the great glory of Sri Vrindavan Dham. This is the great mercy of Vrindavan Dham, which Prabodhanand Pad Saraswati ji is mentioning and is pleading before the land of Sri Vrindavan Dham that I completely bow down to you, I completely request you, I just surrender to you, and I know that you will not let me go in all those bad directions. You will hold me back and you will place me to that level where I'll be playing, I'll be involved in those divine pastimes of Sri Vrindavan Dham. Prabodhanand Pad Saraswati ji Maharaj apne is shlok mein apne aap ko ek बालक के समान प्रस्तुत करते हुए श्री वृंदावन टवी माँ के आगे ये प्रार्थना रखते हुए कह रहे हैं कि हे वृंदा टवी माँ, आप तो करुणाशाली हो, करुणा सिंधु हो, करुणा की समुद्र हो, और आप जानती हो कि जिस प्रकार बालक के अंदर सत असत का कोई विवेक नहीं होता, गलत सही का कोई उसके अंदर सोचने की क्षमता नहीं होती कि क्या गलत है क्या सही है, वो ये बिल्कुल नहीं जानता कि इसमें मेरा अहित छुपा है या हित छुपा है, इसी प्रकार मैं भी ये बिल्कुल नहीं जानता कि मेरा किस चीज़ में हित है किस चीज़ में अहित है, मैं क्या करूँ क्या ना करूँ, पर मैं इतना जानता हूँ कि अब मैं आपके आश्रित हूँ, आप ही मेरी सर्वस्व हो, आप ही मेरी सब कुछ हो, और जैसे माँ अपने बच्चे को अपने पुत्र को कभी भी गलत मार्ग पे नहीं जाने देती, सदैव उसके पीछे पीछे उस डोलती रहती है, जैसे यदि बालक अगर चाकू से खेलना चाहे, सांप से खेलना चाहे, आग से खेलना चाहे या कुएं में कूदना चाहे, तो क्या उसकी माँ उसे ऐसा करने देगी? नहीं, वो तुरंत उसके हाथ से ये सब छुड़ा के उसको तुरंत ऐसी चीज़ों से दूर रख के अपनी बाहों में समेट लेगी। ऐसे ही करुणाशाली वृंदा टवी माँ, मैं आपसे प्रार्थना करता हूँ कि मैं तो बहुत अविवेकी हूँ, कहीं ना कहीं ये सबके अंदर ये ज्ञान रहता है कि क्या असत है क्या सत्य है, क्या गलत है क्या सही है, ऐसे कहीं ना कहीं मेरे अंदर भी थोड़ा सा ये ज्ञान है कि ये सब अमृत तुल्य जो मुझ पे कृपा हुई है इसको मैं त्याग कर विषय रस का पान कर रहा हूँ, पर मैं विवश हूँ, मैं अपने पूर्व जन्म के संस्कारों से विवश होके इन सब चीज़ों में अपने आप को प्रवृत्त महसूस करता हूँ, मैं अपने आप को रोक नहीं पाता हूँ, इसलिए मैं आपसे प्रार्थना करता हूँ वृंदा टवी माँ कि आप ही मेरे अंदर की ये जितनी धूल है जितनी गंदगी है ये सब आप ही दूर कर दो। फिर प्रबोधानंद पाद सरस्वती जी महाराज कहते हैं कि जैसे सुंदर नेत्र रखते हुए भी महाअंधे की तरह दुखों के समूह में मैं अपने आप को फंसा हुआ पा रहा हूँ, क्यों? क्योंकि मैं ये अपने मेरे अंदर ये सामर्थ्य नहीं रह गई है कि मैं अपने आप को इन मोह जनित बंधनों से दूर कर सकूं, इन मोह जनित बंधनों को हटा सकूं। इतना ज़्यादा मेरा अंतःकरण अपवित्र हो चुका है, इतना मलिन हो चुका है कि मेरे अंदर अब ये सामर्थ्य नहीं बची। मैं जानता हूँ कि कहीं ना कहीं मेरा ये राग, मेरा परिवारजनों से ये संबंध, उनके प्रति मेरी मोहाशक्ति मुझे पतित कर देगी, मुझे गर्त में डाल देगी, पर मैं इन सब के बाद भी इन्हीं सब में सुख मान के ना जाने किस कारणवश इन्हीं सब में फंसा रहता हूँ। तो वृंदा टवी माँ, आप तो सर्वसमर्थ हो, आप तो प्रिया प्रीतम को सुख प्रदान करने वाली हो, ऐसी आपकी सामर्थ है, आप तो वृंदावन में ऐसी ऐसी दिव्य लीलाएं प्रिया प्रीतम की आपके गोद में हो रही हैं कि आपकी गोद में ही प्रिया प्रीतम अपने आप को परम सुखी और परम निश्चिंत महसूस करते हैं, ऐसी सर्व सामर्थ्यशाली आप हैं, तो मुझ जैसे अबोध बालक, मुझ जैसे मलिन बालक को आपको सारी गंदगी से दूर करने में आपको कितना समय लगेगा? आपके लिए तो ये क्षण भर का, आपको तो ये करने में एक क्षण का भी समय नहीं लगेगा, आप तो क्षण भर में मेरा पूरा परिवर्तन कर सकती हैं। इसलिए हे वृंदावटवी माँ, मैं पूर्ण रूप से आपके प्रति आश्रित हो चुका हूँ। मैं पूर्ण रूप से अब ये देख चुका हूँ कि मेरे अंदर कोई सामर्थ्य नहीं है, और जैसे एक माँ अपने बच्चे का भरण पोषण करती है, इसी प्रकार हे वृंदावटवी माँ, आप मेरा भरण पोषण करो और मुझे खींच कर अपनी गोद में बिठा लो, क्योंकि अगर आप मुझे खींचोगी तो फिर माया की ताकत नहीं कि मुझे वृंदावन धाम से दूर कर सके, आपसे दूर कर सके, प्रिया प्रीतम से दूर कर सके, और मैं सदा सदा आपकी गोद में बैठ कर श्री प्रिया प्रीतम को दुलार पा सकूं और श्री प्रिया प्रीतम का को दुलार कर सकूं, ऐसी सामर्थ्य आप मुझ में प्रदान कर दो। बस इस बात को ध्यान रखिए, इस बात को हमें ध्यान रखना चाहिए कि ये सब हो जाएगा। हमारी कैसी भी स्थिति हो, हमारे अंदर हम कितने भी बड़े दुराचारी पापाचारी, जैसा हमने पीछे इस विषय में चर्चा की है, कहा है कि कैसे भी हम दुराचारी हों, कैसे भी हमने पाप किए हों, ये सब बात बन जाएगी। बस हमें मुख्यतः इस बात पे ध्यान रखना है कि हमारा वृंदावन धाम के प्रति अनन्य आश्रय हो जाए, हमारी शरणागति में जरा भी रिंच मात्र भी कमी ना हो। यदि हमने अपने हाथ उठा दिए तो अब ये हाथ सिर्फ वृंदावन धाम के सामने ही उठे रहें और किसी के आगे ना उठे, किसी के आगे ना झुके। बस पूर्ण रूप से यदि हम वृंदावन धाम को समर्पण कर देते हैं तो आप देखिएगा इसका चमत्कार कि वृंदावन धाम की कृपा से आपको किस दिव्य रस की प्राप्ति होती है।